Hi everyone, another not really beautiful day in Ireland. Yeah, we're gonna talk today about alcohol. Should you drink it or not? And is it healthy for you? How much to drink? What to do after you drink? All these kind of issues. Alright, so alcohol is actually not that big problem overall. Problem is how people drink alcohol and what we have with it, you know, and do we do like detoxification and everything else. So let's say I drink a lot of alcohol and I have no problem with it at all. But I would not recommend to drink alcohol every single day. I think it's best to have time for drink and have time off drink. So once you drink, you can drink as much as you want. But once you're not drinking, you know, it's best to have like plenty of days in a row you don't drink. You do your detoxification, and you do your cleansing, you eat well, you drink a lot of water, sure enough, and everything should be okay, because liver can repair itself, so you should have no problem with that at all. I would not recommend to drink every day small amounts, like one glass of wine or two glasses of wine. Even is highly recommended by most of the dietitians and the doctors as well. See, I was drinking this way for 1 year, and what I found that my liver was like very toxic, and I had to do like detoxification like for a month just to clean it. So it didn't work well for me, you know. So sure, you may check for yourself, but I think it's best to have time for drinking and time off drinking. So let's say I was now in my trip 14 days and I was drinking 14 days in a row, and I was drinking a lot, so I didn't have any problem at all. So I come back, I'm not drinking now like for 3 weeks in a row, and I feel excellent and amazing, and I was feeling excellent and amazing in that trip as well. So but not everybody was like that, and I can tell you why. Let's say I was drinking with one guy till 4 in the morning, and we together go to sleep, and we met in the morning just maybe after 5-6 o'clock after the drink. So how do you feel? Well, I feel terrible. I say, did you have any water? Say, what water do you have to do with anything? You know, I was drinking so much alcohol. Why should I drink water? I would go to the toilet like 10 times or something, you know, like. When he say, how do you look so amazing? You know, like, we was drinking, like, you was drinking twice as me, and till 4 o'clock, and why you look so good, you know? So I say, look, remember that time we split at 4 in the morning? Yes. I say, look, from that time till now, that's 6 hours, I was drinking 6 glasses of water. I say, wow, you was doing that. Why did you do that? I say, because once you drink a lot of alcohol, you have to get a lot of water, like usual, at least. Like, you should have 2 liters anyway. So I say, you probably don't have that. He say, I never drink water. That's a normal thing, like, people don't drink water, you know. So I say, look, that's why you feel bad. Maybe you should get some now. Well, he wasn't too stupid. Just go to bar and took some water with ice and lime in it. So So he drank a few glasses of that, and I met him in half an hour. I was like, how you feel? I said, better. So that's how it works, you know. If you drink alcohol, don't forget your water. You still have to have at least 2 liters of water, usually more. Better to have more, like 2.5 liters of water. And best, have at least 0.5 liter of water before go sleep, and 0.5 liter of water after you get wake up, you know. And have some water just beside your bed, and so you can drink it wherever you want, you know. You just wake up and you can drink it. And another thing, it's important to have good breakfast. You should have breakfast if you after party. And best to have, like I usually have, same thing, 2 cooked eggs and vegetables. Fruits, not vegetables, fruits. So if you cannot get smoothies or fresh squeezed juices, just get some fruits, you know. Best fruits for after parties: watermelon. Second is melon. It cleans you very well, and you will feel amazing and beautiful. Melon, believe me, that's true. That's why I tried it for myself. I was drinking 14 days in a row, and 14 days in a row I have same breakfast: 2 cooked eggs and 2 plates of, 1 plate of watermelon, another plate of melon, and I got 1 orange, and sometimes I have as well kiwi, you know. So easy peasy, you know. If you have this, you will have no problems with alcohol. All right. So next thing, what is best to drink? Don't forget, if you are a gluten-free diet, beer is not good for you. Beer will contain gluten, and you should avoid beer in this case of situation. So it is actually beer without gluten. It's hard to get. I didn't see any in Ireland at all, but you may have in your country. So just check it up. This beer will be good for you. It probably actually will be excellent for you. Beer is good drink, but problem is gluten. You know, beer drinkers, we are lazy. We always want to eat something. We are fat. How it's happening? Because if you eat gluten, you will want food. That's all what you're gonna think. That's all what you're gonna do, you know. So choices is yours, you know. Like there are diets where you can eat gluten and be healthy. There are diets like I now do, there is no gluten, you know, and you can be even more healthy. So it's up to you. All right. So another thing, whiskey may also contain gluten, so you have to be careful with that. If you buy whiskey, just buy cleanest one, you know, most cleanest, and just check them, you know. Like, I'm not sure myself, not drinking at this moment any whiskey. My favorite drinks is red wine and cognac. So they are both made from grapes. Red wine is known to have resveratrol in it, and resveratrol is like number one for anti-aging effects. So you should want it as much as possible. So, and it's excellent with food, with cheese, just having with your dinner. Sometimes you just speak with someone and have a glass of wine, or just watch TV, you know. So it's just excellent, this thing, you know. So it's probably my favorite. And cognac is more stronger if you want dancing, if you want your blood more circulating, you know. So cognac is good for this, in this case, situation, you know. So that's the drinks I drink. Well, we shouldn't drink any cider. Cider is not good for you. Cider contains sugar. Well, you probably remember I say, like, if you watch my old videos, organic cider vinegar with water is good for you. But remember one thing, all together, organic cider vinegar with water is good for you. If it's organic cider vinegar without water, or is not organic, or is not apple, you know, it's not good. So be careful what I say. It's just organic cider vinegar with water is good for you. Cider is not good for you. You should skip cider. Another fit thing, you can make healthy cocktails. Let's say I was having one party and I was making cocktails with fresh squeezed juices, and this was excellent. Taste is amazing, you know, you get so much vitamins with your drinks. Why not, you know, why not? So that's probably will be all what I can say about alcohol. Choices is yours. If you live a healthy life, if you have enough water, you should be okay with alcohol as well. So just don't forget to clean up after it, you know. Do detoxing, eat well, watch my videos, and you will get all information what you need. Okay, bye-bye now. If you liked my video and want to say thank you, is only a few ways you can do it. First, this is my book. I am a science fiction writer, not only science fiction, also write mystery and philosophical. My books is quite a philosophical, alright, so I'm also a philosopher. So this is my book, see, Martinas Domeika, that's my name, and book called Sole Mie. It's translated to English, I originally writing in Lithuania, and you can buy this in Amazon.com. So you can find this book in Amazon.com, and if you want to say thank you to me, well, it's no point to write thanks for information or anything like that. Things cost today, you know, like things I say, you know, like you will have to read like 50 books about healthy living and watch on internet, like read stuff and watch on YouTube and everything. So I just collect everything and put to few videos, and I save your time. So if you want to say thank you, just buy this book. Also, what you can do, press like on this video and subscribe for my channel, and help me to put that to mass media, you know, put that on your Facebook or Twitter or wherever you can, you know, like, so that's how you can say thank you to me, alright, and I say thank you to you, alright, bye-bye now.